Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about propagation of error. This is very important topic in engineering exams. Here we will discuss about basic rules of addition and subtraction of errors and multiplication of exact values. So how we add or subtract errors? Suppose we have measured two quantities x and y, and these quantities have errors delta x and delta y. We can write these quantities as x plus minus delta x and y plus minus delta y. Now we are calculating a new quantity z, which is the addition of x and y. So we can calculate error in z by using equation delta z equals delta x plus delta y. That means error in z would equal error in x plus error in y. So if any new quantity, which is the addition of x and y, errors would be added too. Same way, if new quantity z is the subtraction of x and y, we have to calculate error in z. Even in that case, we will add the error in x and error in y. So the thing is, we have to add errors in both cases, even in addition and even in subtraction. For example, length of a slab is given and width of a slab is given, and then we have to find the quantity h, which is the subtraction of length minus width, and we have to find error also. So value h equals l minus w. So we can find value h using this equation. So we subtract this and we find the 5 cm. And now we will find error in h. For that, we will add error in length and error in width. So final answer will be h, that is the value h, this one, 5 cm, and plus error, that is the 0.07 cm. Now conclusion is, whether values are being added or subtracted, we always add errors to find final error. Multiplication by constant value. First, let's discuss what is the constant value. Constant value means the value that does not change or have constant number, like pi, gravity and gravitational constant. You can see all these constant have a exact number, like 3.14 or 9.8 meter per second square. So these values do not change. So these constant numbers are exact numbers. So they have zero errors, or you can say no errors. So the same way, if we measure a quantity x and which has error delta x, and then we have to find a new quantity z, which is the multiplication of constant value k and variable x. X is the variable and k is the constant here. So now we have to find the error in z. What we will do, you know, k has no errors because it's a constant value. So the error in z would equal error in x. So let's take an example. Here radius is of a circle given, and we have to find circumference of the circle. Here circumference is the product of a constant value 2 pi and variable r. Then we have to find error in circumference. First we will find value of circumference. That for that we will use 2 pi r formula. We got the value of circumference 12.56 cm. And then error in circumference would be the same error in r, because 2 pi has no error. So we will get the final answer c plus minus delta c, that means value plus minus error. I hope you understand this topic here, and we will discuss multiplication and division of errors in next video. If you have any questions on this topic or any other topic, please ask your question in the comment box given below. Thank you.